So far, we've been a bit fast regarding the conditions under which the probabilities of being in each state converge over time to what we called the steady state distribution of our Markov chain. In this video, we're going to explain in detail those ergodicity conditions. First, let us state clearly what we want. We have a discrete-time Markov chain X, and we want that, starting from any initial state, or even a probability distribution over those states, we want that the probabilities of being in each state converge over time to a vector of probability, pi, that would be unique and positive. That means it should have only strictly positive values. And that will be our steady state distribution vector. To have that, the chain needs to be at the same time irreducible, aperiodic, and positive recurrent. In the remainder of this video, we're going to explain in detail each of those conditions. So let's start with irreducibility. What does that mean? Well, it means that from any state, I should be able to reach any other state in the chain, possibly in several steps. How can I check that? Well, I can use the transition diagram, take any two states, and check whether I can find a path from one to the other using only transitions that have a strictly positive probability. I can also do this verification numerically using the transition matrix if the number of states is finite. Indeed, if I compute p to the power small n for a given n, the term ij of that matrix is the probability of going from state I to state j in n steps. So if I compute that matrix and for different n's and I sum all those matrices, that gives me a matrix. And if the term ij of that matrix is strictly positive, it means that for at least one number of steps, small n, there is a path in n steps from I to j. So I want that to be true for any pair of states. So I need all the terms of that matrix to be strictly positive. And the sum just needs to be from 0 to n minus 1, because if I take two states and if there's a path from one state to the other, there is for sure one that takes at most n minus 1 steps. So let's see on a few examples how it works. So we have here a Markov chain with three states. And we see that from state one, we are able to reach state two directly and state three in two steps. And same thing from state two, we can reach two other ones or from state three. So this chain is irreducible. We could also check that using the condition on the matrices. So p to the power zero is identity plus p squared gives me a matrix, a 3x3 matrix made only of ones. So the condition is also satisfied. The chain is irreducible. What about that Markov chain with only two states? Well, we see that when we're in state one, we're stuck there. No way we can reach state two. And same thing, if we are in state two, we are stuck and will never go to a state one. So this one is not irreducible. We see that on the transition diagram, and so we can also see that using the transition matrix. What about that three states chain? From state one, we can reach state two and state three, but from state two or state three, we cannot go back to state one. So that one is not irreducible, and we can also check that using the matrix. What was important was just that the transition values, the probabilities were strictly positive here I needed to take some specific values to compute the matrix. So the green arrow, the blue arrow, sorry, have probability 0.1, and you can compute the probabilities for the black arrows based on that. So what's the problem with irreducibility? If my chain is not irreducible, what can happen? Well, for sure what will happen is that even if the probabilities converge, they will not converge to a vector that is positive. We wanted the vector to be positive. Because if there is a strictly positive probability of being in one state, then from that one we'll never be able to reach some other state because the chain would be because the chain is not irreducible. So there is at least one state that will have a probability zero, and that was not what we wanted. So we will lose positivity of the vector. But also, which is maybe more problematic, we may lose uniqueness. Like if you look at the first example on the left, if we start in state one, okay, the probabilities converge because they remain the same. We are for sure in state one at whatever time we look at the chain. So, okay, we are in state one, but if we started in state two, we will stay in state two forever. So the probabilities converge, but what they converge to depends on where we started, and it's not what we wanted. So to summarize, if the Markov chain is not irreducible, we lose the positivity of the steady state distribution, and possibly we also lose the uniqueness. The second condition that we would like to have is called aperiodicity. What does that mean? Well, it means that there is no number strictly above one, a number t that would be the period of a state, such that if I want to create a path from a state I to itself, I can only do that in a multiple of t steps. So it will be simpler to see on examples. So how to check that? So it means that I would only be able to do loops in a multiple of t steps. So how to check that? I can take the transition diagram and find a loop in k steps and another loop in k plus 1 steps. That will solve it for me. So in theory, I should have to do this verification for all the states in the Markov chain. But if the chain is irreducible, then we are quite lucky. We only need to do that for one state. We can do this verification also using the transition matrix. Well, it's the same thing that we want to verify. Find a path with strictly positive probability from I to itself in k and in k plus 1 steps. So having the term ii of p to the power k, having that term strictly positive, means there is a path from I to itself in k steps. And so having the same position term ii in p to the power k plus 1 being strictly positive means I also have a path in k plus 1 steps from I to itself. So if the product of those two terms is strictly positive, I have what I want. So it doesn't look very easy to check sometimes, but in most cases, that condition is easy to check, because if I have an irreducible Markov chain, having only one state with a self-transition that is strictly positive, so PII is strictly positive, then it's sufficient to have an aperiodic chain. So let us see a few examples again. So here, our chain with two states and only self-transitions is aperiodic. From state one, we can go to itself in one or two steps. Same thing for state two, and we can check that also using the matrix. What about that chain? Is it aperiodic? Well, we can see using the transition matrices that it is aperiodic, because we can compute p to the power 1, p to the power 2, and all the diagonal terms are strictly positive. And also we see that from the diagram, that we can go from state 1 to itself in one or two steps, same thing for states 2 and 3. Okay, what's the problem now? Why do we want a periodicity? What if we have a periodic chain like this one? So let's first check that it is periodic. Here we see that if we want to loop from state 1 to itself, well, we can do that only in 3 steps or 6 or 9 or 12. It is necessarily a multiple of 3. So we see that state 1 is periodic with period 3, and same thing for states 2 and 3. We can check that also using the transition probability matrix. So P is this matrix, P squared that one, and P to the power 3 is the identity, so that, well, for any k, we have P 1 plus to the power 1 plus 3k equals P, P to the power 2 plus 3k equals P squared, and P to the power 3k equals identity. So we see that there is no hope that if we take two consecutive powers of P, that we find the terms in the diagonal, one term in the diagonal that is strictly positive in those two consecutive powers of P. So this confirms that this chain is periodic. What about that one? Well, it looks less easy, but we have labeled the states to make it appear more clearly that it's also periodic with period 3. From state 1, we can only loop in 1 or in 3 or 6 or 9 steps and so on. Because from state 1, we can only go to a state labeled 2 or 2 prime. From state 2 or 2 prime, we can only go to a state labeled 3 or 3 prime. And same thing, from 3 or 3 prime, we can only go to 1 or 1 prime. So we see that loops can only take a multiple of 3 steps. So that chain is also periodic with period 3. So what's the problem again with if our chain is periodic? Well, the problem is we wanted the limit probabilities to be independent on the time at which we look at, and independent on where we started. But here, let's say with the simplest example, we start at time 0 in state 1. When even if we wait a long, long time, if we look at the chain at a time that is a multiple of 3, then we are sure we are in state 1. If we look at the time, if we look at the Markov chain at a time that is of the form 3k plus 1, we are sure we are in state 2, and so on. At the time 3k plus 2, we are in state 3. So the state we are in necessarily depends on where we started. So that's a problem, because that's something we didn't want. Finally, the last condition we want to have is positive recurrence. So what does that mean? So it means that if I'm in a given state, the expected time before I go back to that state again is finite. Well, that's something that's not always easy to check. Here is a way to do it. Well, if the chain is irreducible and the number of states is finite, in that case, it's easy to check. You actually have nothing to do. This property comes for free. But if the chain has an infinite number of states, that's where it can get more complicated. So we assume that we have a chain that is irreducible and aperiodic, and then a way to do the checking to verify that it's positive recurrent is to do as if everything was okay, and we just try computing the steady state distribution. Let's see on an example. So we have here a Markov chain with an infinite number of states. It's irreducible from any state. We can go to any other state. It's aperiodic because we have a self-transition with probability 1 minus p from state 0 to itself. So I'm assuming here that p is neither 0 nor 1. Okay. So our chain is irreducible, aperiodic, and okay, we can try to compute the steady state distribution. For that, we apply the balance equation. A simple way to do that is just to separate the set of states in two. So here I'm drawing a frontier, and I'm saying that we should cross the frontier in each direction equally often. So here, how often do we get out of the red zone? Well, we need to be in state I minus 1, and then with probability P, I'm leaving that zone. And similarly, I can count how often I enter this zone. That's 1 minus P times pi I. Okay, that's for the balance equation. Then this gives me an expression of pi I as a function of pi 0. Okay, I have expressed each steady state probability, provided I can find them, each steady state probability as a function of pi 0. Then I can use the normalization condition that say that all the probabilities add up to 1. I have an expression of pi I, so I just use it, and I have that pi 0 multiplied by that sum should equal 1. And so, okay, pi 0 should be 1 over that sum, and I'm done. I have all the steady state probabilities. But the problem may occur here is that we need that sum to be finite. And this type of sum is finite if and only if the term here is strictly smaller than 1, which means here that p should be strictly smaller than 1/2. If it's not the case, well, the term p over 1 minus p is 1 or larger, the sum is infinite, and we'll get pi 0 equals 0, which will look suspicious. And that's actually the problem with chains that are not positive recurrent. There are some states that will be visited only a finite number of times and then will never go back again. And here that's the problem. If p is larger than 1 minus p, we see on our example that we will have a trend going right more often than going left. So we will be lost in the infinite states rather than going back from time to time to state 0. So such a chain is called unstable. In queuing system, it's what can happen if people arrive more fast than they leave. Then we don't have a steady state distribution for that because, well, the queue will just explode.